Previously on One Warrior Series, we followed Stamp Fairtex on her journey to the top. Next up, we'll take a look at another promising athlete from the Fairtex gym.
My name is Mark Abelardo. I'm 26 years old and New Zealand-born Filipino. I live in Pattaya, Thailand.
Really well, how are you?
Good, good.
Hey, Brad, hey, how are you, man?
Boss here, Stamp, training.
Yeah. How's it going?
I like that he doesn't, when he sprawls, he doesn't just sit there in the position, just knee and knee, and like he's looking to finish.
Very active, yeah.
Yeah.
So I mean, if you remember that fight he had with Ali, I think there were like two takedowns. Otherwise, it was just all stand up. But I want to see what he can do on the ground.
Yeah.
Ready?
The last time we saw Mark in the ring, it was an amazing back and forth battle against Ali Mutama. It truly was a match worthy of warrior bonuses for both guys. Mark deserved that hard-earned victory.
Do you guys have an ice bath? No, this guy has a messed up back. I wouldn't mind maybe putting him in the ice bath.
This is exactly what I need right now.
Jonathan was doing some deadlifts before we came on this trip.
This is what happens when you get into your late 20s.
Just actually bought a lot of ice.
Yeah,
and then
yeah, that works.
Yeah. Oh, wow, this sucks.
This isn't bad, man. Like, you just gotta, here.
Oh, you're such a, dude, don't do that.
Just relax, just relax.
I hate you so much.
This is my shower temperature. I don't know what you're talking about. This isn't even ice water.
Fantastic. It does feel a lot better. Like, I feel a little bit more mobile.
How long did your dad do karate for?
Years. I don't know how many exactly, but it was, yeah, way before I was.
Did you start? Oh, you never did that.
I did. He started running a school in New Zealand, and I started training when I was about 10 for about a couple years, and then he had to stop just because he got busy with work and family.
So you never got your black belt in that art?
No, I only got up to yellow. I was still young at the time. Yeah.
The karate that your dad did was, how many, is that a very popular style of karate, or?
It was a system that they started teaching, like, way back in the early 1900s, I believe, yeah. And he started a new chapter in New Zealand and started up the Puma Sakatsu there and ran it for about 10 years until, yeah, just.
Are there other schools there, though, or?
No, just the one in New Zealand and just in the Philippines.
Is it still there?
In the Philippines it is, in New Zealand it isn't.
So what do you do when you're not training?
It's just the fight life, you know, you train, eat, sleep, repeat. Yeah.
Except for today, you're doing archery.
Yeah, it's cool, yeah. Better time off.
Have you done it before, or?
Years ago, years when I was young, just in phys ed at school.
You ready, old man?
Hang on, I'm a bit slow.
No. So we're at the archery range, and we're gonna shoot some arrows today, because Mark over here was talking trash since he used to shoot in high school. And I thought that I was gonna have a compound bow to shoot today, but I'm not. It looks like we're shooting recurve, and I'm not very skilled at that, so.
But that's why you're a three-time world champion, baby. Pick it up just like that, right?
It's easy stuff.
Cool.
go ahead, go get it.
Why?
That's so crazy, man. Look at your guy's board, look at my board.
Yeah, but my board was shot in before I got here, in all fairness.
Did you take this as a class in
No, it's just like we're just doing outdoor activities, and this is one of the ones we did.
Oh, really?
So we only did this for a couple days.
Jonathan has to keep walking around. You need help?
What?
Why don't you just say something?
I'm good at the exercise.
I'll come get it. Hold on. You don't need to be bending over.
We're not bending over, we're squatting. You have to use the proper mechanics.
Well, you know what? Hey, that's you're deadlifting an arrow. That's exactly what you did the other day. Got your back hurt.
So I had to go down there to pick up my arrows because I keep aiming high, which is what you should do in all aspects of life, except for archery.
Go ahead, one and one. I'll let you go first since you've been out shooting me all day. Go. I'm just sticking with that area that I'm shooting at. Like, I'm gonna keep them all right there. Oh, nice. My grouping might actually be a little bit tighter, but tighter in the wrong spot. So you win. My job today was to actually come to the range, hang out with a few of the guys, and just shoot some arrows and get to chat, you know. Getting to hang out with somebody like Mark and getting to know him a little bit better was nice. Unfortunately, I didn't do as well shooting a bow today as I would like to have. Mark proved himself to be quite the archer. Nice. And yeah, but we just had a good time.
First thing you need to talk about Mark, he's a very humble man. He doesn't really talk about much of his fighting skills, you know, he's not very cocky, but when it comes to the fighting, you know, everyone knows he's a very, very skillful man.
He gives it 110, 120% full on. What he wants, he'll get. Inside the ring, he's a different person. But outside the ring, he's just a scaredy cat, really. When my brother used to be little, every time he would like wander off in the shopping mall, anywhere, would be like, don't go there, there's a ghost. And he wouldn't go back because he'd be freaking out, like, you know, afraid of them. He was quite chubby when he was little, so his endurance wasn't really there, but he was passionate about it. I think it was because of, I want to do what my dad's doing. I want to do what my sister's doing. You know, I want a black belt.
I was training karate at the age of 10 years old. Under my dad, it was a third degree black belt in Puma Sekatsu karate. My mom, she's always worried about my fights. It's funny, especially when I do fight and there's a live stream or she's able to watch, you know, everyone will be there watching, but as soon as I step on, when I'm on, she'll run to her room.
As soon as the fight starts, she runs into the room and she'll listen to music or she'll just wait until the fight's over. She'll hear us screaming and she'll run and then she's like, yay, like as if she's watched it.
It's sad when we're such a big family and having him away from us is just, it's hard. But in order to change, you just have to, you know, get out of your comfort zone.
Biggest sacrifice would have to be being away from family. A lot of the time I'm away from them for a year and I get to see them maybe a month or two at the end for Christmas and New Year's.
When he first moved to Chiang Mai, when he told me, I was like, oh, okay. At first I thought maybe just a hobby, but I didn't realize it was the real deal, what he wanted to do.
I was just, wow, like everything's changing, you know. Our family's going to Australia, he's going to Thailand. It was a big shock, but we know this was a good chance for him to evolve and become a better fighter.
I was just worried about his mental state, like not being around family. Will he get homesick? Will he come home straight away? Washing his clothes, you know, general stuff like that. But he proved me wrong, you know? And I think it's because we keep in contact every day.
We're very family orientated. It's around 30 cousins of us, and we usually have family gatherings every once a week. Having him not in Australia is kind of hard for us, you know?
We're out here in Pattaya, Thailand, making our way to Koh Lan Island, here with the fam.
We've always dreamed of coming here with Mark in Thailand, and it's just crazy how it's actually happening right now.
Oh wait, who is that?
Nice one. What a great way to spend it then with them here in Thailand, you know, where I stay and get to show them around.
We've got this freshly caught fish that is barbecued and ready to eat. It's feast.
He's good. He caught like how many? 10. He caught 10. He's lucky like I'm not there.
We're going to try some of this sashimi, freshly caught by myself. Oh. Let's go.
Ooh, fresh.
Bit of snorkeling that should go it on.
We're very close when it comes to life experience. He'll ask me for advice, I'll ask him for advice, but usually we talk about more serious things. If it has to do with a big move, like should I go to America? The first thing I always say to him, is that what you want to do? If that's what you want to do, just do it. Whatever you choose, I'll be behind you. I'll help you in any way.
Well, it's gonna be hard going up, bro. They say for anything, patience is one of the biggest keys.
All these opportunities that are coming out your way, just take it. Just take it, because if people are giving you stuff, it means they believe in you, they want you. So you need to just take it. Be happy, you know, you deserve it.
This is going to be good for you, because I know, we all know, that he was going to be a good fighter, a great fighter. And we just knew this was for him.
Mark's going to be the new 1FC champ. You heard it first.
Growing up in school, you know, I was always fluctuating up and down. You know, I was playing a lot of sports, but as I got older, once I kind of started shying away from basketball especially, I got heavily into gaming, going out with friends. I got pretty heavy, maybe about 80, 85 at my worst. And that's when I decided, you know, I want to make a change. I want to get back into sports. And my interest in MMA and jiu-jitsu, kickboxing was pretty high. So I was like, why not train in that? And get fit and get in better shape. Before Thailand, I was actually living in Denver, Colorado for about 4 months. I was staying with a teammate over there, and you know, I wanted to try things out there and see if I could fight. And at the time in Denver, I saw a post saying that one of my previous coaches is now the head coach here at Fairtex. And my teammate and I, we spoke and we're like, should we give it a try? Let's see if we can make a run in Asia.
I didn't see it coming. It was really out of the blue. From karate to video games to MMA. I personally didn't know much about MMA. I didn't know what that sport was about until I saw him training. He joined Strike Force in New Zealand and he lost a lot of weight, a lot of weight. And then I watched his first fight. I couldn't believe it. I was like, wow, this is real. This is what he really wants to do.
Shout.
I'm looking forward to seeing you compete, man.
Yeah, I can't wait to get in there. Yeah,
have you watched film on your guy?
Just that one fight he had at the last show.
Yeah, what were your thoughts?
I mean, it's pretty wild style, but he makes it work, and I heard he's a high-level boxer, so yeah, got some game plans for him.
Cool, cool, man. Yeah, good.
Well, making that big step from the minor shows to the big shows, how was that for you?
Honestly, it was just like another day at the office.
Yeah.
A lot of people get nervous by that kind of stuff, and I didn't, because for me, at the end of the day, after training, after a match, it doesn't matter, I know that I'm my own worst critic. When it came to competition, the only opinions that matter are your opinion and the opinions of your teammates and your coaches, like the people that are close to you.
Come on, Mark!
Nice!
All these people in your life, they own a piece of that victory. Like every time you win, everybody else in your life, like a coach or a training partner or a friend, they've all done something where they can say, I helped him win that fight, because it's a team mentality. So I tend to find that in life, whatever your greatest strength is also tends to be your Achilles heel.
It takes one little thing to put you off track.
That's how important the mind game is when you're competing. People don't realize that. It's way more of a mental game than a physical game.
Oh, for sure, for sure. Yeah, people think you just go out there and fight, but you know, there's so much things behind it, so much things leading up to it that they don't know about. You always feel the nerves leading up to a fight, but once you step in there, once I step in there especially, you know, it all goes away and I'm having fun. Fighting for one warrior is, it just means I'm one step closer to the main goal, and that's one championship. I feel like that's where I belong, and you know, an opportunity for me to showcase what I have and see what if I have what it takes to be at the top.
Can you touch the top? Get your corner.
To your left, please, Mark. To your left. Don't play his game. Keep pushing forward.
Well, he was a very, very aggressive fighter. You know, he showboats a lot. Fought heavy strikers, strong grapplers, so it was nothing new to me. I knew I just had to weather the storm and take the fight where it needed to go. He showboats a lot, but it wasn't going to break me. You know, I've seen all that before, and I was able to capitalize, take him to the ground, and get that stoppage. Everyone at FedEx inspires me. I look up to a lot of the fighters, you know. It just encourages me to be better and train harder and, you know, strive to be the best. So I dedicate this to my family. Sorry.
We just screamed, really. We were just so happy that he won his fight. But yeah, and then the usual, just check his face, if he's okay. For me, I was just really, really happy for him. Like, I tried not to cry. But I was just, he couldn't see me. So, but I was just really, really happy. In general, we were very, very, very happy for him.
Come on, just the back.
Yeah, this is for my family. I do this all for them.
I'm going to award a contract tonight because I saw somebody go through a full-out war in their last match here, and they really impressed me tonight because they had to come through some adversity to win this match, and this one goes to Mark Abelardo. Welcome to ONE Championship, Mark.
For me, it's life-changing because I feel like I'm one of the best here in Southeast Asia, and I feel like I'm not getting the appreciation I deserve. And now that I'm signed, I feel like I'm gonna show the world who I am and what I can do.
The life of a martial artist can be selfish at times. Your social circle will often sacrifice for your training. And although you step into the ring alone, there are so many people invested. Coaches, training partners, and even friends and family. When you win, they share that victory with you. But they also share the defeat when you lose.